Hello farmers, today we will learn about the uses of copper. Copper is used in agriculture since ancient times. In my opinion, if the copper is the systemic fungicide, then there is no need of other fungicide. But copper does not show systemic action. Copper is contact fungicide, bactericide and viricide. We are going to know about him further, and in today's video we are going to know complete information about copper. Please hit the like button before starting so that I can post more videos, since it will be encouraging. You can watch this video on the Expert Agriculture Guide YouTube channel. Copper is the most widely used as fungicide and bactericide in agriculture. Copper is a contact fungicide, so it kills fungus. It is bactericide, so it also kills bacteria and kills viruses of all forms due to its viricide action. Check out this screenshot if you don't believe on it. Copper is acidic pesticide. Copper is also an organic pesticide. Do not use copper in flowering stage. Let us now know about the diseases on which copper works. Copper control downy mildew, late blight, anthracnose, bacterial blight, fruit rot and many more disease. Copper suppresses gibberellin. Therefore, the result of gibberellic acid do not come after the spraying of copper. Copper is also used for chemical thinning. Copper also reduces the effect of nitrogen. Therefore, the leaves of the crop are made rough from it. As a result, the diseases on the crop are very less. Do not mix acidic pesticide while spraying copper. All best copper is a cheap and effective pesticide. First of all, we will know the different type of copper. The first and most commonly used type is copper oxychloride. Second type is copper hydroxide, and the third type is copper sulphate. The last and fourth type is chelated copper. So let us now take a complete look at each type. Copper oxychloride is available and cheap in the market, and they are easy to use. Syngenta company sells this with the name called blue copper. It comes in copper oxychloride 50% WP formulation. WP means wettable powder. Now let us know the next type. Copper hydroxide comes a bit expensive in the market, but believe me, its benefits are also more, along with controlling fungus. The plant also gets oxygen from it. This can be helpful in oxygenating the plant under waterlogged condition. However, its use is very less compared to other formulation. FMC company sells copper hydroxide under the name Cocide 2000, which contains copper hydroxide 53.8% DF formulation. Copper sulfate is very acidic, so it cannot be used for direct spraying. So for copper sulfate spraying, its pH value needs to be increased. When lime is used with copper sulfate, this is called Bordex mixture. A Bordex mixture is more impactful and works for a longer period of time. Hence, it is most popular among farmers since ancient times. Copper sulfate drenching is also used in India to control the diseases like wilt and dieback. For this, 500 grams of copper sulfate should be used per acre in drenching. Now let's learn about chelated copper. The other formulations of copper are too acidic. It cannot be used in spraying combinations alternatively. Chelated copper can be used in the spraying combination. You can combine it with any pesticide. Typically, chelated copper contains 12% copper. In today's special talk, let's learn more about copper. In ancient times in India, making copper solution. This solution is still sprayed on trees in organic farming today. But the method of making that solution is quite different. If you want to know that method, get 10,000 subscribers on this channel, then we will teach you how to practically make that solution. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.